He buried tons of landmines right on the spot gonna execute you. He started digging the hole. Underground tunnel. Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today in this video, I am going to talk about something so unbelievably important. It is about a story of a man in North Korea, how he's been rescuing North Korean people to freedom and eventually got executed. This is what North Koreans do to be free. The freedom that we often take for granted, that we don't even know this is freedom. So please stay till the end of this video and find out about the entire story. And before that, please hit that like button so more people to find out about what is really happening to North Korean people and also the price of freedom. It's almost a luxury for me to sit here and talking about how difficult it is to be free, because I also myself had to cross frozen river, then eventually crossing frozen Gobi Desert into Mongolia and come here. And that is how I got this voice, guys, and telling you about these stories. And today in this video, this is a very special story. As I don't know how many of you follow North Korean issue. Lately, after Kim Jong-un took over, escaping from North Korea has been getting more difficult over the years. And for the last few years, almost escaping from North Korea became impossible. Only a few could make it. And because there's one man who thought differently how to break this hermit kingdom. So Kim Jong-un took power in early 2010, and that's when he started cracking on down defections. So North Korea has a border with China and DMZ, that is with South Korea. DMZ is mostly heavily militarized zone. There's more bombs buried there than a lot of other places in this world combined. Therefore, if you don't know the exact geography, most likely you're gonna be blown up by the landmines and never gonna make it to South Korea. And that is why most of North Korean defectors, like 99.9% of them, go through China. And this border between North Korea and China has to be usually been one river that is going across. It's called the Yalu and Tumen River. I personally crossed the Yalu River into China 2007. And this the town that I am coming from in Haesan, Liangang Province. This is the actual story of a man who just recently got executed. For his crime was actually letting North Korea to escape to freedom. So Kim Jong-un came up with a new idea. So before, people were easily accessible to could go to the river, wash their clothes and drink the water, and they were able to go to the river. And then Kim Jong-un thought, okay, now if I make that entire border with China, that river town, like a DMZ, the most heavily militarized zone, then I can prevent defection. So that's what he exactly did. He put the highly electrified wire fences around the entire border. And not only that, he evacuated people from the 2 kilometers from that border to the inner land. And in between, he buried tons of landmines and put the guards every 10 meters with the machine guns. And he told the guards, if you let anyone escape, I'm going to right on the spot gonna execute you. So for these border guards to let people to escape has become their life. The price for them to let these people escape is like they are literally costing their life and their family lives, because North Korea does something called guilt by association, which means punishing 3 generations of family altogether. Therefore, in the last several years, the escaping from North Korea has been going down. So far in America, officially, there are just over 200 North Korean defectors made to America over the almost last 80 years of time. There are more North Korean defectors residing in South Korea, but it just shows how impossible it is to escape from that country. It is not a joke in this 21st century. The entire country, the population of 25 million who's living in that country, became a concentration camp. So this is a man whose family name was Kim. He was thinking, how do I let people to escape and how do I find their route? That is, which what he did was, he was living in Haesan, and he used to living on the border town, and he had to move inland. And from there, he started digging the hole, underground tunnel. So he dig the underground tunnel from his kitchen, and then dig to the point of the river bank. So imagine this is a river, and the border guards staying here. And now because of the between the border guards and the people's town is there is like 1 or 2 kilometers distance. So all the border guards was looking at was inland, towards the inland. And from there, so they didn't really think somebody gonna make it to the river because there's so much other prevention tools over there. So he dig this like underground tunnel and then letting North Korean to escape through that tunnel. So one day North Korean officials seeing somebody got disappeared and then they couldn't find the body and where did they go? I mean, escaping is impossible. And then after it'll be like hundreds of the got disappeared over the period of few years time, they were thinking something is going on. So they were trying to look, go after homes and homes and seeing what was happening. And they found in the kitchen of Kim's family's underground tunnel. Of course, on the spot, he got captured and he got publicly executed. But because of him, hundreds of North Koreans found the freedom and was able to escape to China, then come to South Korea and America. This is a story, something you would see in the prisons, right? People like escape from prison, digging a hole underground and wall. You don't do such a thing in an entire country. This is what I am doing, what I do right now is that people do not understand how miserable life can be without freedom and how horrible government can be when they take that power and do not give back to people. Kim Jong-un literally made the entire country of 25 million population into a concentration camp. And while we have this passport and move around, North Koreans have to dig an underground tunnel to escape from their own country. Not from a concentration camp, but from just a normal country. While when people say anything is possible, yes, anything is possible. You can be oppressed to the point you have to dig a hole underground tunnel and escape at this cost and be executed for it. This is a time, a lot of days now I'm living in freedom. I also do take freedom for granted. But this is such a great reminder that how precious that freedom that we have, how precious voice that we have. We can totally spending a day looking at a social media post and, you know, just blaming the system and not be grateful for what we have. But also, we also can realize, learning from these people, these people who risking their lives to be free, and all their yearning is freedom, and we have that. We have the precious thing in our hands right now. So let's fight together before we lose it. I am scared living in America right now. Every day that I see the freedom is slipping away from my fingertips. That every day that I am struggling to have a voice as an activist on fighting against big tech censorship. So if you don't want to be like ending up like North Koreans, let's fight together. Please join me on my Patreon and Locals so I can continue to make these videos and educate the world and what the price of freedom and how precious this thing is and why we need to fight for it, why we have it. Because once governments take that freedom from us, they are never gonna give that us back. So thank you guys for watching. And please hit that like button again and share this video with everyone that you know. So people really know, understand what North Koreans go through in that darkness and what they go through to be free. Love you guys, and I look forward to seeing you all in the next videos.